People tell you, my main aim in life is to be able to own the three big buildings in the center of Tobago. I hope Tobago has big buildings, inshallah. My aim in life is to own those three buildings. So he starts working at the age of 10, 15. Perhaps he is so focused and dedicated. Listen to this example. So focused and dedicated that at the age of 50, he owns those three buildings. Wow. What was required to do that? Focus and dedication. Two things. He knew what he wanted. He was focused on it. And he was dedicated. He made sure he got it. And then at the age of 60, the uncle on his deathbed, may Allah protect us all. And then he says, wow, I really am excited. I've accomplished everything in my life. I wanted those three buildings and I got them. Now I'm dying. Goodbye. Would that be a foolish person? Yes, very foolish. Why? Nobody's going to shove those three buildings into your grave and tell the angels, hey, I had the three buildings. No way, not at all. No one can write you a certificate and stick it on your chest to say, hey, angel of death, or the angels who are going to come and ask questions, this man, he was dedicated and focused, those three buildings, he owned them, so now give him easy passage into heaven. Doesn't happen that way. Not at all. But when we are focused and dedicated to earn the building of the Akhirah, to earn that which is in paradise, we will achieve it. It will come into our grave with us, and later on we will see it and we will live in it and we will be smiling. Now, what does that mean? Do not die except in the condition of submission. It means lead your life in such a way that, as you know, death can overtake you at any time. If it were to overtake you right now, would you be amongst those who are submitters unto your own Creator? If the answer is yes, then you are very fortunate. And this is why don't wait to turn to Allah. You know, if we wait to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we wait to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we may never ever get that opportunity. So one thing we should never wait for is to turn to Allah. When we do not have proper objectives and goals in life, we waste a lot of time. We don't know what exactly we want. We don't know where exactly we want to reach. And we don't work towards it. Some people know, I'd like to do this, I'd like to do that. And they don't work towards it. If you don't work towards it, you're wasting time. You're wasting all your time. Because before you know it, time would be finished and you would not have achieved what you wanted. So it's important for us to have proper objectives. And secondly, a point I touched on, your company, your companions, they are also a big obstacle. If you mix with like-minded people who have similar goals and objectives, you will get there with greater ease. Also, being involved in that which is glamorous, that which shines, that which glitters, and chasing it. We heard about the dunya. Those who chase the dunya, let me inform you, it has no end. And we like fools keep running behind. You know, I pictured it once in my mind. I'd seen a load of rats running behind a cheese, a piece of cheese. And as they got the cheese, there was one smelling stronger in front. So they threw this one and they carried on. And they threw the other one. But eat from this cheese and be full at least. I hope you understand what I'm saying. You've got your cheese, the first cheese you've got. And what happens? It goes to motor vehicles, it goes to cell phones, and after that it goes to your spouse. Why? You've got a wife. Oh, she's 1990 model. I need a better, a later model. Why? You developed your habit of wanting the latest. So when you see your wife, she no longer appeals to you. When you see your husband, he no longer appeals. Why? Just like your phone. It no longer appeals. I seen a dude down the road with a better jeans, halfway down his butt, mashallah. May Allah protect us. Who you are and your role that you are meant to play, your objective is made by other people, your friends, your peers, and the media in particular. Every time there is a movie, they come up with a new type of dress code and a new hairstyle, and then you have all these hedgehogs in the classroom. Another very, very important point. Some people have a habit of starting something. Before they've finished it, they start something else. And starting a third thing before they finish the second. When you do something, do it properly, complete it, and then go for something else. This means when you do something, do a thorough job. Some people, and I do know, they start a course. 2 years down the line, no, I don't want to do this course. Go to another one. They do another course, and 2 years down the line, I don't want to do. Well, look, if it happened to you once, probably, maybe it was the wrong field. Maybe you've now chosen the right one. But finish something. Finish it. And your best bet is choose properly from the beginning. Always up. But that's what it's all about. Time is never enough. Never ever. Let's use it, inshallah, in the right direction. Let us make sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning let us make sure that we call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us goodness. Once we have used our time properly and we learn to be systematic in our life, we will feel so good. We will be able to achieve our goals. You know, we will be able to achieve something in life, be happy. We will be able to make sure that every moment we have had has been used in the right direction. And this is why don't wait to turn to Allah. You know, if we wait to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we wait to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we may never ever get that opportunity. So one thing we should never wait for is to turn to Allah. You know, the sisters, subhanallah, even the brothers, sometimes there's a religious decision we need to make. Make it now. Don't say, okay, I'm not, you know, holy enough. I still want to enjoy my life. I still want to, you know, I cannot go for Hajj now. I still need to do this. No. It must happen now. N-O-W. If it doesn't come now, it may never ever come. There are so many examples of it. So if you want to get to a higher spiritual level, let it happen now.